Welcome to Age Akshara Academy YouTube channel. In this session, I am going to discuss Physics JEE Main NEET Thermal Properties of Matter, Problems on Thermal Expansion of Gases, Part 2. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Please share your valuable comments in the comment section. Okay, let us go to the today's session. First question. In this question, a cylinder contains 10 kg of gas at pressure 10 to the power of 7 Newton per meter square. The quantity of gas taken out of cylinder if final pressure is 2.5 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton per meter square. Assume temperature of gas is constant. Here, in this question, they given 10 kg of gas. A cylinder contains 10 kg mass. They given mass as 10 kg and they given pressure 10 to the power of 7 Newton per meter square. And this is the initial pressure and final pressure they given 2.5 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton per meter square. Here, we have to calculate the change in mass. Here, how much mass of the gas leaked we have to calculate. Okay, now let us go to the solution. Given mass m1 is equals to 10 kilogram and P1 is equals to 10 to the power of 7 Newton per meter square and P2 they given as 2.5 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton per meter square. From ideal gas equation, PV is equals to nRT. So this one PV is equals to n. In the place of n, here we are writing m by m r t. P is directly proportional to mass of gas. So P is directly proportional to mass of gas. That is, P is directly proportional to m. So let m1 is equals to initial mass. Let m1 is equals to initial mass and m2 is equals to final mass. M1 minus m2 is equals to mass of gas leaked. This one we have to calculate. Mass of gas leaked. So from this relation we are writing P1 by P2 is equals to M1 by M2. Now substituting values, P1 nothing but they given 10 to the power of 7 and P2 nothing but 2.5 into 10 to the power of 6. So that is equals to M1 they given us 10 kilogram and M2 we have to calculate. So 10 to the power of 7 here, 10 to the power of 6 still here, 10 remaining. This 10 and this 10 will cancel. So by taking cross multiplication, we are getting M2 is equals to 2.5. So now mass of gas leaked, that is equals to here mass of gas leaked, mass of gas leaked is equals to M1 minus M2, that is equals to M1 minus M2, that is equals to M1 minus M2 is equals to 10 minus 2.5, so 7.5 kilogram. M1 minus M2 is equals to 10 minus 2.5, 7.5 kilogram. So therefore, mass of gas liquid M1 minus M2 is equals to 7.5 kilogram. This is the final answer. Okay. Next, we'll go to the next question. The volume of a gas at 0 degree centigrade is 546 cubic centimeter at constant pressure. It is heated from 30 degree centigrade to 50 degree centigrade. Then the change in volume is, here we have to calculate what is the change in volume. Okay, now they given V0 is equals to, now let us go to the solution. V0 is equals to, they given as 546 cubic centimeter, and delta T is equals to, they given at constant pressure volume of gas is heated from 30 degree centigrade to 50 degree centigrade. So delta T is equals to 50 minus 30, that implies delta T is equals to 20 degree centigrade. Now delta V is equals to, change in volume delta V is equals to V2 minus V1, that is equals to question mark. We have to calculate change in volume. So V 30 degrees is equals to V naught of 1 plus alpha T1. So that is equals to, they given as volume of a gas at 0 degree centigrade is 546. Substituting values 546 plus alpha, nothing but 1 by 273.15 into T1 30 degrees. Now 546 into V 30 degrees centigrade. Here taking LCM, 273.15 plus 30 divided by 273.15. After calculation, we are getting V30 is equals to 605.96 cubic centimeter. That is cc. Cc is nothing but cubic centimeter. This is the value of volume of a gas at 30 degree centigrade. Okay. Next, V50 is equals to volume of a gas at 50 degree centigrade is equals to V naught of 1 plus alpha T2. So now substituting values, V naught nothing but they given as 546. 1 plus alpha nothing but 1 by 273.15 into T2, they given as 50 degree centigrade. So that is equals to 546 of taking LCM 273.15 plus 50 by 273.15. Now after calculation, we are getting volume of a gas at 50 degree centigrade is equals to 645.96. So now change in volume delta V is equals to V50 minus V30, that is equals to 645.96 minus 605.96. So after subtraction, change in volume, we are getting 40 cc, cubic centimeters. So therefore change in volume delta V is equals to 40 cubic centimeters. This is the final answer. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. A cylinder contains gas at a pressure of 2.5 atm atmospheric pressure. Due to leakage, the pressure falls to 2 atmospheric pressure. So after some time, the percentage of the gas which is leaked out, here we have to calculate a percentage of gas percentage after which is leaked out. Now let us go to the solution. They given P1 is equals to 2.5 atm atmospheric pressure and P2 they given as 2 atm atmospheric pressure. Pressure is directly proportional to mass of a gas. So percentage of the gas, that is here M1 minus M2 by M1 into 100 we have to calculate. So M1 minus M2 by M1 into 100 is equals to P1 minus P2 by P1 into 100. Now substituting values, P1 they given as 2.5 atm. So now M1 minus M2 by M1 into 100 is equals to, now substituting values, P1 minus P2, 2.5 minus 2 by P1, 2.5 into 100. So that is equals to 2.5 minus 2, 0.5 by 2.5 into 100. Here we are decimal representation here, 5 by, we can write it as 5 by 25 into 100. Here now 5 1s are 5, 5s are 5 1s are 5, 2s are 10, 0. So that is equals to, we are getting 20%. So now the percentage of the gas which is leaked out is 20%. So therefore M1 minus M2 by M1 into 100 is equals to, we are getting 20%. This is the final answer. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. State the equation corresponding to 8 gram of oxygen is. Here we have to write the equation corresponding to 8 grams of oxygen. Now they given here mass of the oxygen is 8 grams and we have to calculate the equation of this state corresponding to 8 grams of oxygen. Let us go to the solution. Given mass of oxygen, M is equals to mass of oxygen, that is equals to M, that is equals to given as 8 grams. And molecular weight of oxygen is equals to molecular weight of oxygen, that is equals to M is equals to 32 grams. Now we are finding equation of state corresponding to 8 grams of oxygen is PV is equals to nRT. So this can be written as M by nRT. This is the small m. So PV is equals to, substituting values, Now we are writing here small m by capital M. So substituting values 8 by 32 into RT. 8 ones, 8 fours. So PV is equals to RT by 4. So the final answer, equation of state corresponding to 8 grams of oxygen is PV is equals to RT by 4. This is the equation. Okay. Next, we'll go to the next question. At NTP, 28 grams of nitrogen occupies 22.4 liters. What is the mass of 5.6 liters of nitrogen at 38 centimeters of mercury pressure at and 273 degree centigrade temperature? Here we have to calculate mass of nitrogen at 38 centimeters of Hg pressure, mercury pressure. Okay, now let us go to the solution. Here they given M1 is equals to here 28 grams. So M1 is equals to 28 grams. And V1 they given as 22.4 liters. And V2 they given as 5.6 liters. T2 they given as 273 kelvins. Now M2 is equals to, we have to calculate. So M2 is equals to, here PV is directly proportional to MT. So from this relation we are writing P1 by V1 is equals to P2 by V2, that is equals to M1 by M2 into T1 by T2. So from this relation we are writing formula for M2. So M2 is equals to P2 V2 by P1 V1 into T1 by T2 into M1. Now substituting the values, M2 is equals to P2, they given as here P2 into V2. P2 they given as 38 grams. P2 is equals to 38 centimeters of Hg. And T2 is equals to 273 plus 273. Here we are converting into kelvins, 546 kelvins. Okay. Now substituting values, P2 nothing but 38, V2 nothing but they given as 5.6 by P1 they given as 76 centimeters of Hg into V1. Here we can write P1 is equal to 76 centimeters of Hg, and T1 is equals to 273 kelvins. Okay. Now V1 is equals to, here is substituting 22.4 liters into, here T1 nothing but 273 by T2 546 into M1 they given as 28 grams. Okay, now here we are doing cancellation. 38 1 ja 38 2 जा एंड 5.61 जा 5.64 जा 273 1 जा 273 2 जा 546 सो द रिमेनिंग इज 28 बाय हियर 24 जा 8 8 2 जा 16 सो m2 इज इक्वल्स टू वी आर गेटिंग 28 by 16 that implies m2 is equals to 28 by 16 we are getting 1.75 grams therefore m2 is equals to 1.75 grams this is the final answer okay next we'll go to the next question A vessel of volume 4 liters contain a mixture of gas, 8 grams of oxygen, 14 grams of nitrogen and 22 grams of carbon dioxide at 27 degrees centigrade. The pressure exerted by the mixture is, here we have to calculate pressure exerted by the mixture. They given as volume 4 liters. And M1 8 grams and M2 they given as 32 grams. M2 is equals to 14 grams. Now here let us go to the solution. So given V is equals to 4 liters and M1 is equals to 8 grams. And here m1 nothing but molecular weight that is equals to 32 grams molecular weight of oxygen is 32 grams and m2 they given as here nitrogen mass of nitrogen they given as 22 grams so here sorry m1 they given as 14 grams and this is 22 grams nothing but mass of carbon dioxide okay now this molecular weight of nitrogen is 28 grams and mass of carbon dioxide m3 is equals to 22 grams and molecular weight of carbon dioxide is equals to 44 here 44 grams now t is equals to we are converting this here they given 27 degree centigrade converting into kelvins by adding 273 so that is equals to we are getting 300 kelvins now as pv is equals to n1 plus n2 plus n3 this is the pressure exerted by the mixture pv is equals to n1 plus n2 plus n3 into rt so this equation can be written as n1 nothing but m1 by m1 plus n2 nothing but m2 by m2 plus n3 nothing but m3 by m3 into rt so this is the equation now p is equals to this equation can be written as p is equals to m1 by m1 plus m2 by m2 plus m3 by m3 into rt by v so now we are writing expression for p p is equals to that is equals to m1 by m1 plus m2 by m2 plus m3 by m3 of RT by V. Now we are substituting the values. M1 nothing but 8 by 32. M2 by M2 nothing but 14 by 28. And this 22 by 44 by V. They given as 4 into 10 to the power of minus 3. R 8.3 314 into T 300 kelvins. Okay, now this equation 8/32 plus 14/28. Here we are taking cancellation. 8 ones are 8 fours. 14 ones, 14 twos. 22 ones, 22 twos. So that is equals to, we are getting P is equals to 1/4 plus 1/2 plus 1/2 of by here 4 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So this can be written as, here we are 10 to the power of minus 3 going this side. It becomes by 4 into 8.314 into 300. Here 10 to the power of minus 3 becomes 10 to the power of plus 3. That is 10 cube. So now you are taking cancellation. 4 ones are 4 and here 4 twos are 8. And again here 2 two table 2 2 4. Here 2 4 8 and 2 1 2 2 5 2 7. So and again 2 1 2 2 1 50 300. Okay, so here and again here we are doing now, but here this complete taking cancellation. Now we are doing LCM. 1 plus 2 plus 2 by 4 into, we are getting 2.157 into 150 into 10 cube. And again doing cancellation, here 2 2s are 4 2 75 is 150. Now 2.5, here 2 plus 2 4 4 plus 1 5 5 by 2, nothing but 2.5 into 4.157 into 75 into 10 cube. So this is, now we are writing next last after multiplication, P is equals to 779 into 10 cube. So finally we are getting, this can be written as 7.79 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square. This is the final answer. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. 16 gram of oxygen gas and x grams of hydrogen H2 gas occupy the same volume at the same temperature and pressure. Then x is, here we have to calculate the x value of x. Here in this question they given 16 grams of oxygen gas and x grams of hydrogen gas occupy the same volume at same temperature and pressure. Here we have to calculate the how many grams of oxygen gas occupying here. So now let us go to the solution. Given M1 is equals to 16 grams and this molecular weight of oxygen is 32 grams and M2 we have to calculate. Mass of hydrogen gas is given as x grams and this molecular weight of hydrogen is 2 grams. V1 is equals to V2 and T1 is equals to T2 and they given that same volume at same temperature and pressure. So volume, temperature and pressure, the three quantities are same. So V1 is equal to V2, T1 is equal to T2 and P1 is equals to P2. So PV is equals to nRT. n in the place of n we are writing this m by m r t or m by m is constant. So, okay, now from this relation we are writing m1 by m1 is equals to m1 by m2. So substituting values now, 16 by 32 is equals to here m2. So x by 2, 16 ones are 16 twos are. Now here 2 2 gets cancels, so x is equals to 1 gram. So therefore mass of hydrogen gas x is equals to 1 gram. Okay, this is the final answer. Okay, next we'll go to the next. In this question, a gas at temperature 27 degree centigrade and pressure 30 atmosphere is allowed to expand to 1 atmospheric pressure. If the volume becomes 10 times its initial volume, the final temperature becomes. So now here in this question, the given temperature of the gas is 27 degree centigrade and pressure 30 atmosphere is allowed to expand 1 atmospheric pressure. Here volume becomes 10 times to its initial volume. So we have to calculate final temperature. So now let us go to the solution. Now P1 is equals to, they given as 30 atmospheric pressure. Now let us go to the solution. P1 is equals to 273. Now we are converting into kelvins. 273 plus 27, that is equals to 300 kelvins. And P1 they given as 30 atmospheric pressure, and P2 they given as 1 atmospheric pressure, and V1 is equals to V, and V2 is equal to they given as 10 times to initial volume. So final temperature we have to calculate. So PV by T is equals to constant. This can be written as R P1 V1 by T1 is equals to P2 V2 by T2. So now substituting values, then we get P1 is equals to 30 into V by 300, that is equals to 1 into 10 V by T2. Here VV gets cancels. Now here 3 1 ja, here 0 0 gets cancels, 3 1 ja, 300 ja. So taking cross multiplication, T2 is equals to 100 Kelvin. Now converting into centigrade, T2 is equals to T2 minus 273 degrees. K is equals to, C is equals to K minus 273. So now we are converting this 100 kelvins in terms of centigrade. So that is equals to 100 minus 273 degree centigrade. So that is equals to, we are getting minus 173 degree centigrade. This is the final temperature. Therefore T2 is equals to minus 173 degree centigrade. This is final temperature. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. A vessel is filled with an ideal gas at a pressure of 10 atmospheres and temperature 27 degree centigrade. This is not 270, 27 degree centigrade. Half of the mass of gas is removed from the vessel and temperature of the remaining gas is increased to 87 degree centigrade. 87 degree centigrade. The pressure of the gas in the vessel will be Now here we have to calculate pressure of the gas. Now they given. Now let us go to the solution. Given P1 is equals to 10 atmospheres and T1 is equals to converting into Kelvin. They given 27 degree centigrade. Adding 273 plus 27 300 kelvins. And M1 is equals to M and M2 is equals to, they given as M minus M by 2. Half of the mass of the gas is removed from the vessel. So that's why here we are subtracting M minus M by 2. So we are getting, taking LCM 2M, 2M minus M, M by 2. So next T2 is equals to, converting here they given 87 degree centigrade. So here we will write T1 is equals to 27 degree centigrade and T2 they given as 87 degree centigrade. So T2 is equal to, converting into Kelvin, adding 273 to 87, it becomes 360 kelvins. So now P2 is equals to, we have to calculate. P is, next we are writing P is directly proportional to MT. So from this relation we are writing P2 by P1 is equals to M2 T2 by M1 T1. So P2 is equals to, taking cross multiplication, we are writing M2 T2 by M1 T1 into P1. Now substituting values, M2 nothing but M by 2. T2 360 by M1 M, T1 300 into P1 value 10. So now here we are cancellation, M gets cancels, 0 gets cancels, this 0 gets cancels, 3 1s are 3 12s are, and again 2 1s are 2 6s are. So P2 is equals to, we are getting 6 atmospheres. So this is the final pressure. Therefore, P2 is equals to 6 atmospheres. This is final answer. Okay. Next, we'll go to the next question. In this question, at the top of a mountain, a thermometer reads 7 degrees centigrade and barometer reads 70 centimeters of Hg. At the bottom of the mountain, the barometer reads 76 centimeters of Hg. And thermometer reads 27 degree centigrade. The density of air at the top of the mountain is dash times the density of the bottom. Here we have to calculate density of air at the top of the mountain and density at the bottom. Now let us go to the solution. Given T1 is equals to, they given as 7 degrees centigrade, converting into Kelvin. So T1 is equals to 273 plus 7, that is equals to 280 kelvins, and P1 they given as 70 centimeters of Hg, and P2 is equals to, they given as 76 centimeters of mercury Hg. So T2 is equals to, they given as 27 degree centigrade. We are converting T1 is equals to 273 plus 27. We are getting 300 kelvins. So rho 1 by rho 2 is equals to, we have to calculate. So now we are writing this term. V is inversely proportional to rho. Now from this P1 by rho 1 T1 is equals to P2 by rho 2 into T2, as V is inversely proportional to rho. So from this we are writing rho 1 by rho 2 is equals to, taking cross multiplication, P1 T2 by P2 T1. Now substituting values, P1 is equals to 70 into T2 300 by P276 into T1 280. Now here 0 0 gets cancels, and now 14 2 28 and 14 5 70. So now again 2 1 2 2 15 30. So again we are taking 15 5 75. So now P1 row 1 by row 2 is equals to, we are getting 75 by 76. So this value approximately equal to 0.986, or we can written as 0.99. So therefore row 1 by row 2 is equals to, approximately we are writing 0.99. this is the final answer. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. At the bottom of a lake where temperature is 7 degrees centigrade, the pressure is 2.8 atmosphere, an air bubble of radius 1 centimeter at the bottom rises to the surface where the temperature is 27 degrees centigrade. Radius of air bubble at the surface is, here we have to calculate the radius of air bubble at the surface. Now let us go to the solution. Given T1 is equals to, here they given as 7 degrees centigrade. Converting into Kelvin, T1 is equals to 273 plus 7, so that is equals to 280 kelvins. P1 is equals to 2.8 atmospheres, and R1 they given as 1 centimeter, and T2 is equals to, they given as 27 degrees centigrade, and converting into Kelvins, 273 plus 27, that is equals to, we are getting 300 kelvins. Now pressure P2 is equals to, they given as 1 atmosphere. Now we have to calculate radius of air bubble and surface. R2 is equals to ? So here for example this is a lake, and here we are taking the small air bubble, and this pressure P2, here volume V2 and temperature T2, here P1 V1 and temperature T1. Okay, now from ideal gas equation PV by T is equals to constant. From this relation we are writing P1 V1 by T1 is equals to P2 V2 by T2. Now V1 nothing but, here we are taking volume of this sphere 4/3 pi r1 cube. So substituting in the place of V1, 4/3 pi r1 cube by T1, that is equals to P2 into 4/3 pi r2 cube by T2. So here 4/3 and pi gets cancels. The remaining equation is P1 r1 cube by T1 is equals to P2 R2 cube by T2. Now we are substituting values P1 R1 P2. Now we are calculating R2. Now substituting in the place of P1, 2.8 into 1 cube by T1 280, that is equals to P2 1 into R2, we have to calculate R2 by T to nothing but they given as 300. So now next 2.8 into 1 by 280 is equals to 1 into R2 cube by 300. So this here we are taking cancellation 2.8 into 28. 2. Now decimal representation we can write 28 by 2800 is equals to R2 cube by 300. 28 ones are 28 zero zero. So here this 00 and this 00 will cancel. Now R2 cube is equals to here. We are getting here 1 into cube 2.8 into 1 by 280 is equals to R2 cube by 300. Here 28 by 2800 1 0 0 cancel here 3 taking cross multiplication 1 into R2 cube 1 into 3. So R2 cube is equals to 3. Now R2 is equals to we are getting 3 to the power of 1 by 3. So therefore the final answer, that is radius of air bubble at the surface R2 is equals to 3 to the power of 1 by 3. This is the final answer. Okay, next we'll go to the next question. During an experiment, an ideal gas is found to obey an addition law V square P is equals to constant. The gas is initially at a temperature T and volume V. When it expands to a volume 2V, the temperature becomes, so here initially the volume is V. When it expand to V becomes 2V doubled, then what is the temperature? Here we have to calculate. Let us go to the solution. Here we given V square P is equals to constant. V square P is equals to constant. Now P, this can be written as V square RT by V is equals to constant. Now this V square V gets cancels, so V into T is equals to we are getting constant by R. Constant by R, that is equals to constant. So VT is equals to constant. Consider this as equation number 1. Now V1 is equals to V1 and T1 is equals to T and V2 is equals to they given as 2V. So T2 is equals to we have to calculate. So from first equation VT is equals to constant. From equation 1 we can written as equation 1 nothing but Vt is equals to constant. So this can be written as V1 T1 is equals to V2 T2. So substituting values V into T is equals to V2 nothing but they given as 2V. 2V into T2. Here VV gets cancels and T2 is equals to T by 2. This is the final answer. So when it expands to volume 2V, the temperature becomes half. So T2 is equals to T by 2. This is the final answer. So temperature becomes T2 is equals to half of the initial temperature. T2 is equals to T by 2. Okay. Thanks for watching this video.